Now, here's a question that gets asked a lot. I know people are concerned about this. This is Monica Jones. She says, "Hey, Shug, what is the real probability of coming across bears while backpacking? That is the only thing I worry about when I'm in the backcountry." Sure, that's where they live, man. That's where they reside. It's like walking through a zoo. You're going to see some animals. They're behind bars. You go out into the wilderness, well, they're roaming free. But for the most part, they don't want to see you. All right? Go to a campground where there's car camping, where people have coolers of wieners and hamburger buns, and, you know, the food is out everywhere, jars of peanut butter cakes and all that. That's where you're going to see the bears most. Now, on a hiking trail, I always say, be vigilant. You know, look for signs of bear scat. You know, if you see fresh bear scat on the trail, well, that bear has gone one way or the other up and down that trail, because the animals walk on the trails just like you do. It's the easier route. If I have a sense there's one in the way, I get the video out and talk. I sing, la, 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 la. The main thing is, do not hike with worry. I've hiked with people that were so scared of bears in the woods, it ruined their trip, thus ruining mine. And I've never hiked with them again. Be vigilant, but don't worry. Don't let it wreck your trip, all right? Hang your food at night. When you set your camp, make sure you're not setting right on an animal trail. I mean, there are some techniques to this. Different states have different kind of bears. If it's grizzly country, whole different game. But here in Minnesota, it's black bears, but I don't take them lightly. Usually when I see them, the few times I have, they're running away from me. I'm seeing the rear end going. At the least, carry some bear spray and carry it on your pack where you can get to it, and make sure you know how to use it. With bear spray, they sell dummy bear spray that you can take it, and so you know how to work the top. I sprayed bear spray once in my backyard here, just testing it out, and it kind of blew back on me, and I slept in my hammock out in the backyard that night, and it was warm weather, and I was wearing shorts when I shot it, and that Caspian pepper, man, my legs burned and itched all night long, and that was just a light dusting. Bear spray is not a guarantee. It could make you feel more confident about being out there. Some people like to carry firearms. That's their choice. I didn't grow up in a firearm family, so I don't want to carry them in the woods. It's just not my thing, but do whatever you got to do, but don't let it wreck your trip. Go on out there and enjoy. Hope that you see one, because it's probably seeing you as you walk by. All right, this is more of a serious question, and this is from Pojo Woe. "Good Lord, I feel like I'm crying. Love the jam, Shug. Thank you. That was us playing Whip and Post. Here's my question, if you don't mind. As someone in the arts who may be of similar mindset, have you ever suffered anxiety, and could you offer any advice?" Well, yeah, I think we've all suffered anxiety. You know, some people talk about, you know, "Oh, I had a low day." You know, and some people, it's crippling. I am an alcoholic. I'm sober for 30 years now. And through that, and don't congratulate me, because there's nothing to congratulate me about. It's horrible. All right? I have to look inside every day at myself and look for the good parts of myself. All right? And exploit those. And exploit those to myself and to other people. But yeah, I've gone through periods of anxiety. Mine were not crippling. I find ways to turn them around. Backpacking is one. Activities. Get out and work. Playing music. That takes care of things. Doing art, flying my control line airplanes. Anything I can do rather than sit and dwell on it, get out of the house, cooking, you know, making these videos. It all makes me less anxious. It's a way you've got to fulfill your soul. So, you know, you take a look inside every day, you acknowledge the dark or the hurting stuff, but there's always good stuff. You just have to look around for it a little bit more and ride with that. All right. I know some people can't do it without medications or nothing. Believe it or not, I've never been on any medications or anything. And I know some people think I'm crazy. I did go through a year of therapy, and my therapy did tell me this. "Well, Sean, I think when you were drinking, you were probably manic. But since you've quit drinking, I think you have a good handle on manic energy, and you know how to take it up to the edge and jump over the line and then jump back quickly." And he's right. That's what I do. I try to control emotions and the way I feel. It's a life's work. I've gotten way better at it from like the age of 45 on. Here's one of the best things I ever learned. When my daughter was 4 or 5, you know, I was going through this year of therapy. I just wanted to find out if I was crazy, because people always tell me I'm crazy. All right, I didn't want pills. I just wanted to talk to somebody. What I found out is I'm a spirited introvert, but the best thing I learned, if I'm in one of those moods where I'm just kind of pissy and pensive and terse, is to go to Meg and Ariel and say to them, I know I seem like I'm in a bad mood today, but let me tell you this. It's not you making me feel this way. It's me making me feel this way. I'm not reaching my goals today or meeting my own personal potential. And believe me, I set a pretty low bar for myself. But it's a life's work. You can't quit working on it. You have to constantly work on yourself. It's called self-awareness. So I think we all get anxious once in a while, but find ways to alleviate it, to pop the pressure. Sometimes you just gotta let it go and don't care. I like to run around in my panties once in a while and shock people. Brian Weber asks, my only question to you, Shug, is what is the driving force behind you starting your YouTube career? Like I said earlier, it wasn't really a definite choice to start on YouTube. I'll say this, though. So I talked about putting my first video on YouTube in order to get it over to Hammock Forums and put the link over there so people could watch it. I started to realize people watch these videos. You know, I was getting an audience and people were subscribing and people were starting to ask me questions. And one thing I'd like to say is, I know back when I was researching stuff on YouTube, it drove me nuts to ask somebody a question on their YouTube video. You know, they did a video on something. I asked them a question that maybe they didn't cover or I didn't understand, and they didn't answer me. And I'm looking, I'm going, well, they've only got, you know, 125 views. I know they're seeing this comment. Everybody on YouTube looks at their comments. Why not answer me? So I made a vow to answer everybody. I don't have the self-esteem to ask you to subscribe or to like me, and I never will do that. I figure if you like what I'm putting out, you'll subscribe. If not, you don't. Doesn't matter to me. Like me or don't like me, I can't ask you that. I just, you know, if I go and watch a YouTube video, especially somebody that's got five videos and the first thing is going, hey man, subscribe to my channel, give me a like, I immediately click them off. I don't know, it's kind of a dink that way. So what you're asking about this YouTube career, it's not a career, it's become kind of like a side job. I mean, I make a little bit of money on it with the ads that are on the thing. I have to pay taxes on those, but it's just, this is like me mowing lawns on the side. You know, a little something I can do on my days off. I like doing it. It gets me to go out camping, and it gets me some free gear once in a while. But I enjoy it, and I'll continue to do it as long as it's fun. Steve Summersell. Shug, what's the origins of your signature saying, Whoo Buddy? You know, if you go back on my videos, and it's like, I think it's 2008, is my very first video that I ever did.
Whoo Buddy. Gonna be another great day.
I don't know where that came from. I had never said that before in my life. Now, I do have a good friend who's from Texas, and once in a while he'd say, Boy Howdy. I think Whoo Buddy came from Boy Howdy, but my own version. And I was out there, and when I'm in the woods, I'm excited, I'm thrilled to be there, and Whoo Buddy came out. And on a serious note, when people ask me about my religion thing, or one man asked me once why I don't thank the Lord more when I'm out there, well, my Whoo Buddy is my shout out to you, to the staff up above, to whatever deities are out there, to whatever powers, to the animals that are letting me walk through their woods, to the worms, to the earth, to the trees, to the rivers. Maybe I got a little bit of Wicca in me. I love the Native American culture too, where they respect everything. My Whoo Buddy is my shout out to all of that, going, thanks for letting me come through. I don't have a chip on my shoulder. Just coming through your neighborhood. I'm going to enjoy it, and I love that. Okay, here's a funny circus story. We're playing Washington, D.C., and with the train parked, it was a pretty rough area. I mean, I guess what they call the hood. So that wasn't going to deter me from trying to sneak away from the train and having a night out by myself. So that was a night. I had my unicycle, ran over the train tracks, got to the road, rode off. No circus people caught up with me. I was on my own. And I went up the street, and I just wanted to go to a bar and go drinking, because I'm Irish, and that's what I did in those days. So I go in this bar with my unicycle over my shoulder. I open the door like a classic movie. Arrgh! The whole place stopped and looked at me. And then everybody went about their action. I sauntered to the bar. I sat down, ordered a drink. You know, while I was waiting, I got on the unicycle and bounced up and down on it. Let everybody know I was there. I was cool. Hey, how's it going? You know, Sean Emery. With the circus down there. Hung out a while. After a while, I was juggling billiard balls and everything. I was back sitting at the bar, drinking a beer. And here's what happened. I felt this presence behind me, all right? And what he did was, this big black guy, he leaned over me. So I was just looking at his shoulder. He didn't make eye contact with me. He said, hey, man, you want to know why you're still here? Still alive? And I went, Yes, sir, I'd like to know how. He said, you won't come in here with no chip on your shoulder. Then he looked at me, leaned off, went on his way. I learned a very important lesson in life that night. Don't go places with a chip on your shoulder, all right? Walk in with a bright spirit. I mean, don't be a chump. It's the same hiking in the woods. I hate to say this, it sounds weird, but I think the animals like me out there. I've come face to face with wolves. We've never had a problem. I mean, I'm not out there to eat their food or steal their youngs. I'm just passing through. I might be spending the night, but it's kind of like a good house guest. I'll just stay with you one night, buy you some toilet paper and milk, and then I'll move on. So I like to think that I'm out there and the animals kind of go, hey, that guy, he's cool, man. He's cool. He's all right. He's all right, man. I mean, you know, check him out. We watch him a little bit. But he'll move on. He's going to keep moving. He ain't going to stay around. He's all right. That's how I feel about it. I think your intention where you go somewhere shows. And why not bring a good one? You know, it takes a lot of energy to be an angry person.